Let us understand more about CTQ, critical to quality. What are the characteristics? There are two kind of terminologies that we use in Six Sigma. One is VOC. Whenever it is related to VOC or voice of customer, we can say it is CTC. CTC means it is critical to the customer. And whenever it is related to voice of business, we say CTB. CTB means critical to business. But for a common understanding, we say CTQ. So whether it is CTC or it is CTB, in the Six Sigma language, we call it CTQ only. Let us take some examples so it will be more clear. Identify following as a CTB or CTC. For example, on-time delivery. It is CTC. CTC means critical to customer. If you don't supply on time, customer is affected, so it is critical to the customer. Accuracy of the billing statement. It is CTB and CTC also. Because if your bills are not accurate, customer is also affected and your business is also affected. Time to repair. It is CTB, critical to business. Let's say in your organization, if some equipment is not working and you have to send for repairing and that repairing time is more, you as a business is getting affected. Accuracy of the purchase order, critical to the business. Rework at turning, critical to business. Cycle time for assembly, critical to business. Boiler efficiency, critical to business. Number of the customer complaints, critical to customer. But for a common understanding, we can say it is CTQ. Whether it is CTC or CTB, we can use a common terminology called CTQ, that is critical to quality. In Six Sigma, we also use terminology like big Y and small Y. What does this mean? Big Y is a parameter that we measure and monitor at an organizational level. Small Y is a parameter which we work at a process level where we are doing the projects. For example, if we say we want to improve the profitability of an organization, this is called big Y. This cannot be taken as one single project. If you want to take this as a project, we must divide this into many small projects. That is where the scoping of the project comes into play. Let us understand the difference between big Y and a small Y and what is the relationship with the CTQ, critical to quality parameters. So here in this example, we are saying that timely processing of order is considered as a big Y. This can be affected by two things. One is how many orders that we are receiving per hour and what is the time that we take to process an orders. Now further, the average orders received per hour, there are two small Ys, which is number of the orders received by phone, number of the orders received by online method. Time to process an order, there are two small Y. One is time to enter the order, another is time to arrange the shipment. So if we see this, we have four small Y for one big Y. So we can take the project at a small Y level in the Six Sigma. So we have to define our project scope according to this. This is how we can understand the difference between a big Y and a small Y.